power to seize nothing without a demand. It's only fitting that we are having this book launch on Juneteenth, a day when Union troops had to ride into Galveston, Texas and notify the slaves that they were supposedly freed, emancipated. But those of us who are woke, as we say, know that in America, free ain't free. Again, today is symbolically on point because during chattel slavery, during the initial stages of colonization of African and New African people, it was illegal for a slave to be taught how to read and write. It was illegal for a slave to possess such knowledge and skills. And here it is, I, a modern day slave, held behind enemy lines in the prison industrial complex, held by force in the Commonwealth of I'm getting some playback. D.
Yo.
I'm getting playback.
All right. Start over with the prison industrial complex part.
Oh, no. Shit, where is it at? All right, you ready?
Yep.
You ready?
Hang on. Yeah, we're good.
All right. And here it is, I, a modern-day slave, held behind enemy lines in the prison industrial complex, held by force in the Commonwealth of Virginia, which was slash is the heart of the Confederacy, and able to use the weapon of knowledge of letters, words, and sentences to fight back, to raise awareness, to educate, enlighten, and organize. And yet in these modern times, when people talk about being free, they still treat us like it is illegal for us to read and write, as they ban our books, remove our beloveds and new Jim Crows from libraries and schools, as they attack critical race theory and equate it with terroristic thought, as subversive thought, as unpatriotic. I will give them the last one, definitely unpatriotic. This is as Trump shouts from the podium that he plans to, if elected, attack and get rid of all critical race theory and so-called wokeness, as prison administrations and racist or ignorant mailroom clerks prevent the delivery of incoming books, create extensive book bans, lists from the autobiography of Malcolm X to The Bluest Eye by Toni Morrison, as our history books are now called racist or terroristic, as the powers that be and their servants, people who hate freedom, people who are afraid of equality and self-determination, now seek to erase certain peoples and demographics out of the history books, to erase our contributions to not only this society and empire, but to this world. This is the new era of the crusades of burning books, of burning witches that don't submit or follow the rules of patriarchy or male supremacy. With respect and solidarity, we are strong and unified and can move mountains. For those that doesn't know, Indiana is one of the places where the Klan originated, down in the Terre Haute area. The good old boy network still exists and is even more entrenched and legitimized within the prison system and the Indiana legislature, for just two examples. We have the ingredients right now in Indiana to create a mass movement that is a serious threat to the corrupted and established power base and force it to change, if not bring it down or abolish it. Base build in your community, form collectives and cooperatives, book clubs that hold political education classes, turn empty lots into community gardens where we can pass out food to the local community, engage our politics and programs, each one reach one, teach one, rebuild, then struggle in solidarity. Shaka Shakur.